Farid Premani once again with Ignite the Spark, and topic for today is how to create diversified products, how to target the niche, and how to start your own startup and make money. Let's talk about some action today. So there are different theorems, there are different laws, how you go through that. And whenever we say startup, people try to confuse again with someone who is young, graduated. Trust me, if you think this is not right. Any decent startup that has made money has been handled by an amateur who has usually decades of experience, and then they use those professional and entrepreneurial experience to grow the startup to next level. So don't confuse that. Maybe this is startup, this is not right for me, I'm too old for that. You're never too old if you really want to make money and make your dreams come true. So first thing that we always discuss about is any business or any startup that you really want to do that takes you to the next level, you should have passion for it. You should know that this is what I want to work for, if I really get money or not, period. It could be helping others, but you need to make distribution. What do you mean by helping others? By counseling them, by giving them food, shelter, by grooming them, by teaching them, by giving them free clothes. What else? There are different definitions of help as well. To you, in your capacity, how do you want to help them? And you know, that help, there is a another school of thought which says, if you want to be billionaire, identify a product that could serve masses and just charge $1 per person and sell to billion people. So what is that thing that you love and you can sell it to billion people for $1? Let's take that as a benchmark today. So let's say you have a flair for serving people in food. You like food, you're a foodie guy. And you know that food is something, it's a pulse item, you know. It might grow as a bubble, but it's difficult to retain. And anything that might grow as a bubble, you need continuous improvement. You need continuous product development. Let's say Steve Jobs developed the Apple. He said that people usually don't know the product until it's launched. They have a blur idea of it, but when they see the product, they say, oh yes, this is what was in my mind. So only 5% people in this world actually have that clarity in definition. That's why not everybody is good with goal management. So you need to justify getting into their shoes of what exactly they want, and by hit and trial you get to that point of product development. So let's say staying to the food, now you want to see that, is it something a food itself, or is it something a food delivery service or a value-added services? Let's say you say forget about producing food, there are a lot of vendors. Maybe I can go with something producing the food chain. Maybe it could be a delivery channel. Then let's say you say, okay, who are competition in space? DoorDash, Uber Eats, XYZ, you know, you name it. Try to identify and put them all, let's say in an Excel sheet, you know, put their prices, put their number of customers, put their growth, and see why, which company has grown to that level. Let's say if somebody started in 2007 and today in 2019, they have 100,000 customers, and somebody started 2016 and in 19, they have 200,000. Why and how are they different? Why they were able to get, is it the more marketing money that they were able to put to get customers, or is it a free marketing product? Is it something that is a pull product rather than getting push, you're pulling customers to you? How are you going to start that? Identify them, and then on the basis of your metrics, do a SWOT: strengths, weakness, opportunity, threats. It's a common metric. You just Google SWOT, you can figure out. And then based on those competition, it's to say that, you know, if you want to be successful, there are two ways of doing it. Either develop something which is very new, or follow the successful niche, develop something better than that, and you will also be successful. You know, we have to study the competition and see, combining all the strengths in your products and taking all the backdrops or withdrawals, flaws from your product into a new one. Try to develop a pitch out of it, test it. See if the market is ready for your idea, or do you think the market is too saturated? Let's say if you think about launching Uber today in 2019, you might feel that, oh, the market is saturated, there are a lot of drivers, there are a lot of public. But no, companies like Uber, and they're growing day by day. But the thing is, you can target a niche. You might target a specific range of patients who have food allergies or who want specific diet plan, and say, I am the food specialist and I develop that kind of food product for XYZ number of patients. And see if that kind of patients is that decent number who can pay your bills and make you a millionaire. Go for it, man. Who's stopping you? So I hope this helps you out. We tried creating a series-wide product, food product, which will serve, let's say, Alzheimer's patients, you know. They have these kind of protein diets suggested. Nobody wants to take hassle in this life to develop that kind of product. Maybe you deliver Alzheimer's-specific food, or let's say diabetes-specific food, you know, or maybe nut allergies or something kind of food. Brand yourself in a very exact way that people could figure out how you can serve the masses, and it could be a 1% or less than 1% market. The world is big, 300 million plus people. If you can just pick 1% niche, nobody can stop you making money. I hope this helps you. Farid Premani, meeting the underscore.